Okay, so 40 minutes cut off it was. So, able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, as I told you that it comprises of four main states, Calicut, Chirakkal, Cochin, and Travancore. Calicut was under the rule of the Zamorins. So, Zamorin of Calicut you would have heard of, because Zamorin of Calicut was the guy who received this guy. Zamorin's Major Hengi generation. Zamorin of Calicut received the Portuguese, first Portuguese, Vasco da Gama, okay, on the shore of Calicut, right? So what happened later on, all these got merged under only one rule, that is Kerala state. But out of all of them, Travancore was the most powerful, as I have already told you that it is because of Marthan Varma. He was a leading statesman and was a respected leader in his national and the international affairs. This guy was very well read. He defeated Dutch in Kerala. The Dutch people also entered, right? So he defeated them in Kerala. So Hyder Ali invaded Kerala in 1766 and he took over the area of Malabar. I told you that Malabar area was not under the control of Hyder Ali earlier, but later on he captured it, right? I just told you now. Hmm. Yes or no?
Yes.
So Malabar wala jo area hai, he captured from these guys. Yeah, he captured the Malabar area from these guys, right? Next is, there was a remarkable revival of the Malayalam literature here. Now, his successor, now, because of these guys, the Malayalam literature became so, so famous. And this language, and now, because of the efforts of these guys only, you can see that today, the, Kerala is performing the best in all terms, right? In terms of controlling the population, in terms of literacy, in terms of sex ratio, in terms of higher education, they are performing better than any other state. It's because of such people who are the leaders there. And there was another reason as well. What was the other reason? That it was undisturbed for maximum period of time. So the diagram of Travancore, if you see, it was as it is. The state of Travancore was as it is since the beginning of the British era till our independence. It was as it is. Okay. Because south tak jo hai log pahunchte hi nahi the, wahan tak beech mein hi unki itni wars aur ye jange hoti thi ke south mein jo hai woh zyada disturbance nahi hota tha. That's the reason why these people focused more upon their education and human development index, right? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so इनके जो successor थे, he is recognized in the world for his art, for his painting. Raja Ravi Verma, if you could remember, we in our painting section discussed about Raja Ravi Verma. I told you about Raja Ravi Verma there. I told you that this guy would always again come in our modern Indian history when we will discuss the Kerala state. So successor of Marthan Varma was Raja Ravi Verma. He received an international gold medal and international prize for his painting of a Nayar lady. So he painted a Nayar lady of South embracing her hair, right? So आपने देखा होगा ऐसा females जो सिर पे एक जूरा type बांधते हैं, अगर आपको पता होगा. तो वो जूड़ा बांधते हुए उन्होंने एक फोटो बनाया था, एक पोर्ट्रेट बनाया था जो बहुत फेमस हुआ वर्ल्ड ओवर, एंड ही रिसीव्ड द प्राइज एज वेल फॉर दैट. सो ही वाज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ कीपिंग हिमसेल्फ अपडेटेड, लाइक ही यूज्ड टू रीड न्यूज़पेपर्स, जर्नल्स, लंदन, कलकत्ता, मद्रास, सब जगह की पब्लिश्ड जर्नल से पढ़ते थे. ठीक है, अभी देखो ये डायग्राम मैंने आप लोग को बता रहा हूँ. ठीक है, अब ये डायग्राम मैंने जो दिया है आपको, उसमें आप देखो टाइम पीरियड क्या लिखा हुआ है यहाँ पर, 1979 to 1947, राइट? इसका मतलब ये उसको डिस्टर्ब ही नहीं करा गया जो मैप है उसको, समझ में आ रहा है? भले ही इट बिकेम अ पार्ट ऑफ सम रूल और इट रिमेन द पार्ट सेपरेटली, बट द diagram or but the map and the boundaries of this state remained as it is since till our independence. So somewhere or the other you can say that is the major contributor for the development which we can see in Kerala today, because it was not disturbed much. Yes, तो ये एनालिसिस वगैरह भी पूछ सकते हैं. यस क्लियर. ओके लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द अदर रेबेलियस स्टेट्स एरियाज अराउंड दिल्ली. दीज वर दीज बिकेम रेबेलियस बिकॉज दे फॉट अगेंस्ट मुगल्स फॉट अगेंस्ट देम. And because Mughals fought against them, the issues started. I have already informed you about Aurangzeb's crushing hand, which was demolishing different kingdoms. So they had their revenges to be taken now. So Rajput states, agar hum log dekhe, Rajputana, Rajput areas, jo hai Rajasthan area, yahan par Delhi ke aaspaas mein ye rebel states aur powerful hone shuru ho gaye, decline of Mughal Empire ke baad se. So अगर ऐसा नहीं है यहाँ पर ऐसा नहीं है कि भाई राजपूत में आपस में बहुत अच्छी कोऑर्डिनेशन थी ऐसा भी नहीं. देयर वाज ट्रेचरी देयर वाज यू कैन से फाइट्स अमंगस्ट देमसेल्व्स एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल दीस फाइट्स देयर वर ओनली अ फ्यू रूलर्स हु केम टू द पावर. वन अमंगस्ट देम हु फॉट ओवर द कंपटीशन एंड इंट्रीग एंड ट्रेचरी वाज दिस गाय हुज इमेज आई हैव जस्ट शोन यू हियर. He is known but Raja Savai Jai Singh, right? Raja Savai Jai Singh of Amber. Getting this idea? So he was a statesman, a lawmaker, a reformer. He was also a scientific guy. Why? Because he made Jaipur, which is the pink city, on the scientific grounds. How? All the major roads of Jaipur, they cut each other at right angles.
Right angle, yeah.
They cut each other at right angles. So much so, he was so influential in terms of scientific perspective. He developed certain scientific stuffs like observatories in Delhi. So, Jantar Mantar gaye ho kabhi Delhi mein?
No.
So, Jantar Mantar jo hai, wahan par ye observatory banayi gayi hai. Samajh mein aa raha hai? To ye observatory jo hai, isme kaisa hai ki wo time par to ghadiyan nahi hoti thi. तो टाइम कैसे पता करें. तो ही मेड एक्यूरेट क्लॉक्स एंड देयर वर सम ही यूटिलाइज सम टेक्निक ऑफ मेकिंग समथिंग ऑन द ग्राउंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द शैडोज दैट दोज इमेजेस और दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स वर मेकिंग ऑन द ग्राउंड. ही यूज्ड टू फाइंड आउट द पोजीशन ऑफ द अर्थ विद रिस्पेक्ट टू सन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू मून एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. यस So his astronomical observation was remarkably accurate. So he got Euclid's elements of geometry translated into Sanskrit. हमको संस्कृत ही बराबर नहीं आती. इसने वो जो वहाँ से पढ़ा है English को संस्कृत में translate किया. और यही नहीं इसके अलावा trigonometry की भी जो किताब है उसको भी translate किया है. He knew the use of logarithm and Napier's work on construction who also got translated. Yes. He was a great social reformer, guys. How? You would have seen that Rajput spent a lot, a huge amount of money on the marriages of their daughters, right? You would have seen that.
Hmm.
And their stature into the society is judged on the basis of the expenditures that they did in their daughters' marriages. What, being a ruler, he understood what he told to the people that it is incorrect. This is just a perception. People spend the money, huge amount of money, and later on they find difficulties in managing their day-to-day affairs. So it's better that you stop spending huge amount of money. That's incorrect, right? But still, even him being the ruler, he partially failed. There was one more guy amongst Marathas, Parshuram Bhau. Parshuram Bhau.
Bhau.
Parshuram Bhau, one amongst the Marathas. He was the guy who. Along with this, I mean, I'm not along with this, who was also the who also agreed to the same point, and he also wanted to bring in some reform, but he also failed. Why? Because the society doesn't accept things. Getting this? Society jo hai, social thinking jo hai, wo ruler se bhi upar jaati hai hamare idhar. Agar aap dekhe, ruler bolega, wo ho jayega, aisa nahi hai. So he ruled for quite a long period of time, for 44 years. Yes, so this was the state of Rajputana at this time. There were some other rulers as well around, like Jats. I told you when I discussed about third battle of Panipat, I described the name of a Jat ruler, Surajmal Jat. It would have, if you could remember. I told you that he was the guy who advised Nana Sahib Peshwa to not to take pilgrims and the entertainers along with him. If you could remember, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Did you remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so he was the guy, Raja Surajmal Jat from the Jat tribe. He advised Nana Sahib Peshwa that you don't carry, because in the third battle of Panipat, they were going to fight against Ahmad Shah Abdali, and Ahmad Shah Abdali was very, very strong. We know that. He was very, very strong. So what he said, that you don't carry the extra people along with you because those are not warriors and you definitely have to feed them. You need to have extra food. You'll have to have extra protection for all those people that you won't be able to provide. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So he is this guy, Raja Surajmal Jat. ठीक है तो जाट जो है ये एक ट्राइबल कैटेगरी है शी लिव्स इन आगरा दिल्ली मथुरा एरिया आफ्टर द डेथ ऑफ औरंगजेब दे स्टार्टेड क्रिएटिंग अ ह्यूज डिस्टरबेंस इन दिस एरिया दे प्लंडर्ड वेल्थ फ्रॉम एक्सक्यूज मी दे प्लंडर्ड वेल्थ फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट एरियाज इन द रीजंस अराउंड दिल्ली हाईएस्ट ग्लोरी दैट अचीव्ड एट द टाइम ऑफ राजा सुरमल जाट एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू बट ही वाज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज प्लेटो ऑफ जाट राइट अ प्रिलिमिनरी क्वेश्चन काइंडली अंडरलाइन दैट यस आफ्टर द डेथ ऑफ राजा सुरजमल जाट दिस एम्पायर डिक्लाइंड दिस स्टेट डिक्लाइंड बिकॉज देयर वाज नो अदर बिग रूलर हु कैन डेफिनेटली लीड देम क्लियर नेक्स्ट इज द टाइम ऑफ सिख रूल Yes. So, आप लोग जानते हैं सिख रूल किसने स्टार्ट किया? ये फोटो जो है आपको दिख रही है टॉप राइट कॉर्नर में किसकी फोटो है?
गुरु नानक
राइट नाउ
यस सर
सिख रिलीजन इनसे वाज स्टार्टेड बाय गुरु नानक And since then, there had been 10 gurus. And the 10th guru, that is Guru Gobind Singh, was the last
guru. Guru Gobind Singh.
Right, was the last guru.
Yes.
And after that,
yes.
they stopped having the concept of guruship. Why?
Right.
They stopped having, aaj nahi koi guru unka na. Aaj Sikh Empire, aaj Sikh classic religion, da koi guru nahi hai. Kyun aisa?
Their ninth guru was killed, I think, for that reason.
He was killed, but after that, 10th guru also came, no?
Yes, sir.
So why after 10th, 11th did not come? Yes, Shruti, can you explain me this?
Sorry, sir, I don't know.
Okay. So, guys, understand, it's all about observation, right? What happened when the knowledge was being passed from one guru to the other guru? It was observed by Guru Gobind Singh that the knowledge was being corrupted. Knowledge was being corrupted, right? So, one guru gave teachings to the other guru gave teachings to the third guru. Likewise, it kept on passing from one generation to the other generation. Now, he was a bit skeptical about the originality of the thoughts of gurus. Why? Because if, let's say, he dies and after that, there is someone who is the next guru not having an ethical thought, definitely would spoil the Sikh religion. Yes?
Hmm.
So what it is, after this, the teachings of gurus were written in a book called as Guru Granth Sahib. If you go into you would see one big book kept in between, and Gurbani is read from that, and people go and listen to it. Yes or no?
Yes.
Gurbani are the thoughts of the gurus that must be followed to implement in your life. Getting this idea? So that's the reason why Gurudwaras are so beautiful places to visit. Understand that. If you have never visited, you kindly go and visit. You people stay in Andheri, I suppose. So Andheri, you have a Gurudwara near the metro station.
Yes, sir.
Right? To go and visit once. Yes, there is no restriction. I have visited multiple times. I have visited many Gurudwaras in Punjab, in Delhi. So I tell you, you visit. There is a book which is kept in between, and the thoughts of gurus are explained, and these are read, and even that's in actually Punjabi language, right? You won't be able to understand the Khadi Punjabi basically, but still, I'm explaining the concept of guruship, how it ended, right? Why? Because once the things are written into Guru Granth Sahib, nobody can corrupt with it, right? मैं आपको एक चीज बता रहा हूँ, आप दूसरे आदमी को कुछ दूसरी चीज बोल सकते हो, लेकिन एक किताब झूठ नहीं बोलेगी. यस और नो? राइट? दैट वाज द कांसेप्ट व्हिच गुरु नानक सॉरी गुरु गोविंद साहिब इंप्लीमेंटेड, एंड दैट वाज क्वाइट लॉजिकल एंड अ वेरी नोबल डिसीजन. नेक्स्ट इज एट द एंड ऑफ द 15th सेंचुरी व्हेन गुरु नानक ही फाउंडेड इट, these were just the Jats, these were the Jats, right? The Sikh religion spread,
yes.
And these among the peasantry, and the peasants became and started following Sikh religion. But these were not the warriors, if you see. It was Guru Hargobind Singh, right? So Guru Hargobind Singh, he converted them into the warrior saints, right? So just by being sane would not serve the purpose, because you need to protect your area as well. So he started making them a warrior state. What happened when Guru Tegh Bahadur, who? Guru?
Tegh Bahadur.
Tegh Bahadur. Tegh Bahadur, he got killed by Aurangzeb's men. He was a ninth guru. So Guru Gobind Singh, he made a group called as Khalsa. The Khalsa group had an intention of fighting against Mughals. Am I clear with this?
Yes, sir.
But while explaining you the later Mughals, I told you that after the death of Aurangzeb, the first leader, Bahadur Shah, he reconciled with Guru Gobind Singh and had a very
good
relationship. He became friends with Guru Gobind Singh, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. He became friends with Guru Gobind Singh. So, as such, the main idea of Khalsa group was lost. But there was one guy who was a follower of Guru Gobind Singh. His name was Banda Bahadur. Getting this idea? Yes?
Yes, sir.
His name was, when Guruship ended, this Banda Bahadur was the guy who led the Sikh empire, the Sikh rule. Yes? So what happened? Now, Banda Bahadur was supporting the lower caste of the Sikh empire, Sikh rule, Sikh area. Because of which, not only the Mughals, because of Mughals he died. He died because of the inner upper caste people of his own religion. Getting this idea? Because of his support tendered to the lower caste people within his religion, the higher caste people did not like it. And that was the main reason of internal disunity which led to the fall of Banda Bahadur. I told you that Banda Bahadur was captured and executed by Farooq Siyar, right? Am I clear with this, guys?
Yes, sir.
It's a parallel story going along with the Mughal Empire, right? The invasion of Abdali and Nader Shah gave Sikhs an opportunity to rise once again, because Ahmed Shah Abdali and Nader Shah, they were attacking Delhi continuously. Between 1765 and 1800, they become very, very strong. They had 12 mizzles, 12 smaller confederacies, smaller areas, which were called as mizzles. Kya bolte the isko?
Mizzles.
मिसल्स, राइट? अब क्या होता था, ये जो मिसल थी, हर एक मिसल का एक रूलर होता था, बट ऑल ऑफ देम वर अंडर वन सिख रूल. एम आई क्लियर?
देयर वाज, सर कैन यू रिपीट?
या, ऑल दीस कॉन्फेडरेसीज दे हैड वन लीडर leading that confederacy, whereas all those leaders were reporting to one ruler, like Banda Bahadur, right? अब इसी मिसल में से एक मिसल थी जिसका नाम है सुकर चकिया मिसल. क्या नाम है? सुकर चकिया मिसल. ये जो सुकर चकिया मिसल थी इसका एक लीडर, he will now lead the complete Sikh empire. His name was Ranjit Singh. Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Are you clear with this? So if you see this image on the top right corner, this is the image of Ranjit Singh. So he was head of Sukar Chakya Mission. He rose to prominence. He knew that if he doesn't lead it, definitely the Sikh Empire would fall. Now, during his reign, you would say the Sikh Empire was the most powerful states of India. Yes, so he was very brave, diplomatic, born leader. He extended his area from Lahore, which is in Pakistan, till Amritsar. He even extended to Jammu and Kashmir, you can say the Peshawar and Multan area. All these areas were captured by him. So from east of Satluj to the west of Satluj, he was having the complete area under his reign. But what happened? Because of this vast expansion, he was not able to have a very strong control on both the sides of the river. Because of which, British took an advantage and now they attacked Jammu and Kashmir. Mark my words very carefully. This point I will connect with to you in the modern post-independence period as well, even after 1947, post-independence issues of Jammu and Kashmir. Now the current issue of Jammu and Kashmir is because of this reason. Understand that. The original residents of Jammu and Kashmir were Durrani tribes. So Durrani tribe, the Pathan tribes, were the original residents.
Yeah.
The history as we know, were the original residents of Jammu and Kashmir. But what happened? Because of this, they started moving towards the Middle East area. And there were certain attacks. Like, so after that, what happened? Raja Ranjit Singh, jo hai, he captured that area. And after Raja Ranjit Singh, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, British captured the Jammu and Kashmir area. And once they captured, they sold it right away. I don't know why they captured, but after just capturing it, they sold it. Because I think they found it to not to be very, very fruitful for them. So British ne kya kiya? Inse jeet ke usko bech diya. Kisko becha? Gulab Singh ko. Kinko becha?
Gulab Singh.
Dogra Empire. So when we got independence, the king was Hari Singh. King was Hari Singh, who was the successor of Gulab Singh only. Am I clear?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Hari Singh was not having a very good relationship with the leaders of Pakistan, but he was having a very good relationship with Jawaharlal Nehru. So, on the insistence of Jawaharlal Nehru, he signed an agreement and got added one article into our constitution, that is Article 370, specially meant for Kashmir. So, when he signed this agreement with Lord Mountbatten, he wanted the state to be protected as it is. Right? So, it is very hard for us to say that those people, if they do not accept India as their nation, they should leave the country. We cannot say that. It is very wrong to say it. Because those people belong to their nation. That is their land. Okay, we nowhere can say that they should leave the country. Getting this idea? Because they are the original residents of that place. All those people who don't know the history about it, they keep on speaking unnecessary stuff about all these issues. Yeah, so, but I'll connect this issue in our modern Indian history as well about what is the current issue going on, right?
Yes, sir.
So, are we clear with this, guys? Ranjit Singh? So, Ranjit Singh was a very tolerant guy. He was, though he was Sikh, he was having the same rules for Muslims, Hindus and everyone. He incorporated the people from all the religions of the country. There were Hindus, there were Muslims working for his court. There were different commanders from different religions from in his army. And I already told you, British forbade Sikhs from crossing Satluj River in 1909, and this is where he lost the Kashmir region. British conquered and sold it to whom? He sold it to? British sold it to?
British sold it to Gulab Singh.
Right? Gulab Singh. Okay, so I think the time is up for us for this session. And the slide is also over of one lecture as such. So these are the questions. I want you people to write the answers and explain it to me in the next lecture in first 10 minutes, right? So you have the questions with you, right? Discuss how weakening of the Mughal Empire led to the growth of smaller kingdoms in India. I've already explained to you. This question you'll be able to write in a better way once we complete all the Indian states. Okay, we have not completed all the Indian states. We are yet to finish Bengal, Awadh, Hyderabad. Yes. We will complete that in the next lecture, right? So, next is, do you think that kingdoms in 18th century in India were religiously tolerant? Question mark, illustrate. So you can explain the kingdoms which were very much tolerant, like you can explain about Sikh Empire, Kerala, discuss about Mysore Empire, all these empires, they were very much tolerant, right? So explain about them.
Yes.
Political disintegration during 18th century gave a hint to British that they can become the masters of the region, right? So this is quite true, because there was a political disunity. These people were making their plans against some other empire, other ruler, but they were not knowing that they're fighting against each other, and there is a foreigner who has come, and this foreigner would take everything away. They were not having any idea, even a single percent idea of whether the British would prove to be so dangerous to them, right?
Right.
So guys, if you have any questions, you can ask me, otherwise we can call it a day. And the next is timetable would be released to you soon. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So it would be Saturday, yes, Sundays only, right? It would be Saturday, Sundays only. Yes?
Okay.
Yeah? Okay, guys. So,
yes, sir.
Thank you very much. I want you people to write the answers of the today's question and these questions as well that I have just. All these questions are similar questions, but there are differences in their answers. Understand that, right? Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can you just briefly tell me about case studies, to solve case studies?
So have you taken the case studies from Jignasa?
Yes, sir. I'm giving her.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Shruti, why did you attend the first lecture of case studies?
Sir, because I have an internals, you have to work in an NGO. So I go to work in an NGO. For 30 hours, I have to work there. So at that time only, I have to work in that NGO. No? So the time were clashing and I have to complete it till July end.
Okay. That's a very easy stuff. Jignasa, you attended that lecture, right?
Yes, sir.
What I want you to do is, the other day I had explained it by making a chart over the slides, right? You would have taken that down.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So good chart jo hai sabse pehle abhi share karo Shruti se, theek hai? And then
explain, yes, sir.
Ke kya kya cheeze kaise kaise case study likhni hai. So uske baad bhi agar Shruti to mujhe poocho, theek hai? Aur wo jo hai wo chart se banao, theek hai? जब किस किस टाइप की केस स्टडी होती है, क्या क्या पूछा जाता है, वो मैंने दिया हुआ है इनको लिख के, ठीक है? तो वो अगर आप पढ़ोगे तो सबसे पहले क्लैरिटी आ जाएगा, जो मैंने लिख के दिया हुआ है, जो नोट्स दिए हुए हैं उसमें सबसे पहले क्लैरिटी आ जाएगा। उसके बाद अगर और कुछ डाउट्स रह जाते हैं फिर भी तो फिर बोल दीजिए, राइट?
यस ओके सर।
तो श्रुति, सैटरडे संडे सूट यू, राइट?
सैटरडे होता है सर, अभी सैटरडे भी होता है, बट आई थिंक मैं पूछती हूँ, आप अगर छुट्टी हो गई तो मैं फिर ये लेक्चर अटेंड करूंगी।
हाँ, मैं वही कह रहा हूँ कि ये ऑनलाइन सेशंस आप लोगों के लिए इसलिए हेल्पफुल है कि आप कहीं पर भी रह के थोड़ा सा एक दो घंटा निकाल के बाहर आ जाओ, उसके बाद थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा टाइम काम कर लो, चलेगा ठीक है। बट कैसा है कि
अटेंड, ठीक है
अटेंड दिस सेशन, ठीक है
ठीक है
सर, लेट मी नो एंड जिन्यास शेयर दोस प्रीवियस केस
स्टडी, यस यस सर आई
yesterday's case study give to her and explain her. I know you will be able to explain it better now. Okay?
Yes, sir. I have understood. I'll explain.
Okay. Okay, guys. Thank you. See you.
Thank you.
Thank you.